Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. What if your browser could book meetings, draft emails, and do research for you? Today we're going to look at 10 business use cases for Perplexity's new browser, Comet. Let's get into it. So today we're going to see how Comet can reduce your work, increase your productivity with step-by-step demos that you can copy. So let's get into it. Okay, let's get into Comet. So if you want to find out about Comet and download it, then go to perplexity.ai/Comet. Yeah, it's a beautiful website, personal AI assistant, and they've put a lot of effort into this website. Go and have a look. It goes through a lot of things it can do, and you've got a download button here. I think downloading may still require an invite, but I know that they are rolling this out to more and more people. So go and have a look. Get Comet, and then you can start playing along with this video and trying to copy what I'm doing. Okay, when you start on Comet, this is the page that you get to, and so you can just go in straight and ask, and this is a Perplexity ask, so you have all of the Perplexity tools available to you here. There's also these widgets, so there's a try the assistant. You can have some stocks and shares, the weather. Bit cooler in the UK today, and then they've got these YouTube links here, Office, Teams. You can tie up these to Perplexity. I haven't, because those are work tools and I don't have them tied up to my personal Perplexity account. And then a clock, and you can have your address in there as well. I've changed this for my privacy, so I don't have people turn up at the door. You can edit widgets, etc. So first thing we're going to do is as you can see, I've got a whole load of tabs open here. We're going to go to a portal, and this is Birmingham City Council, register on the Supplier portal. And what I'm going to do is open up Assistant. So I've got this Supplier portal, and I've said, please register me on the Supplier portal. Don't submit, I need to check it. So Assistant now is looking at the Birmingham Supplier portal, and it's preparing to initiate the registration system. And so it's going through making the registration. You can see it here. Here is the registration that it's going through with Birmingham City Council. It's finding some errors, so it's having to work its way around. And as you can see, it is put this blue line around it so you can see it working. Go back to here. Most of the details are filled out. The system flagged a duplicate registration. Okay, so here it has filled out information. This is all dummy information that I put in, but it shows you that if you give Comet your details, then it will be able to do this for you. So there you go. That is demonstration number one, getting Comet to just go through and do your supplier registration details. And you could give it a whole load of different organizations and set it off to do your supplier details for you. So that is demonstration one. Let's move on. Next thing I'm going to show you is how you can use Comet to go through your calendar and find available slots. I've got my calendar open. I've said book out 1 hour each evening from 5 to 6 for reflection. Now, of course, you could do this. You could do this yourself, but really nice having this doing it in the background. And of course, I can now go away. I can go away and do something. I can go into ChatGPT. I can go and have a look at the web, whatever. Go back, and it's making all these bookings for me. Okay, so there we are. It has put a reflection time in for my every evening from 5 till 6. That'll be nice. Okay, I've filled up my week with stuff, and so what I can do is go in and ask to find me 3 1-hour slots. So I said, find me 3 1-hour slots for an online meeting next week. So it will look at my diary and identify times when I might be available for a meeting. And of course, you can do this yourself, but remember, this is something that is I can set going and I can come back to later. So here we go. It's found me 3 available slots. Monday from 8 till 9. Yeah, there's one. Monday from 10 till 11. 10 till 11. Monday, 10:30 to 11:30. So it's found me three on Monday. Great. So I've said, so it found me the three available on Monday. And I said, find me the earliest available slot on Wednesday and book it for a meeting with Paul. If it can do that. So I expect it might do an 8 o'clock meeting or an 8:30 meeting. Might pop it in here. You can see it's using Python. So it's going into my, when this blue line comes round, it's going into my diary and it's creating an event. So it's identified when the slot might be. If it calls it meeting with Paul, it has. It's even capitalized my P. When's it going to choose? It's got the right, it's currently on Monday and I said I wanted it on Wednesday. So will it go to the 5th of September? And there we go. We have a meeting with Paul, 8 to 9 on Wednesday the 3rd. Very cool. Use Comet to manage your diary. Absolutely superb. Let's move on. Okay, so one of the things you can do, so let's just open a new thread. One of the things you can do, so I'm in the calendar, but actually I don't want to do stuff on my calendar anymore. So I'm going to put in at, and I want to put in my inbox. So what I've said is in my inbox, and I just put at and then select the inbox, please identify all the invoices I've received in the last 6 months. So if you're doing your finances and you're trying to make sure that you are claiming for all the things you paid for, then this is a great way of going through your emails and making sure you don't miss anything. Here we go. Here are all of, so my Canva, my Google Play, booking.com, Wondershare. So it's given me a list of all my emails. So I'm going to say, create a spreadsheet with all these details in, please. Can it do that? So it used a bit of Python programming. Very cool. Let's create a spreadsheet. There we go. And we've got a CSV file. Have a look what we've got. Download the data, should all be in here now. And there we go. All my invoices that I've received in the last 6 months. Very cool. All right, let's move on. Okay, so here we've got an email. I've sent it to myself. Paul, could you please send me a list of the latest 10 blogs on your website? So what I'm going to do is say to my assistant, I've said, please draft a response drawing the information from this tab. Okay, so that's the tab. That's my blog site. So hopefully what I wanted to do is draft a response to me and go onto the website and identify the last 10 blogs and put them into the draft. Let's see what it does. Now drafting a response. So it's introducing me. Okay, so there we are. We have a draft response. Thank you for your interest. Rather than just a list, I'll give you a quick overview. Here's the what the blog is focused about. So it went on to my blog site, found out what the site was about. Just go back. There we go. And then here's the latest 6 blogs on the site when they were put on. Welcome, comment, and discussion on the site. Please feel free to engage. Fantastic. And I can just send it. How cool is that? How useful is that? So not only responding to an email, creating some sort of generic response, but then saying, going one step further, go and have a look at this particular website and draw the information from that and then include it in the email. That is useful. Let's move on. Okay, so say you're wanting to do a competitor analysis or create a pitch deck. So here in Comet, I put in a prompt, create a table of the top 8 UK EV charging competitors with columns. And I want where the HQ is, core offerings, pricing signals, latest funding, and 3-sided links per company. Follow pagination if needed, then export to a new Google Sheets named EV Pitch Competitors. Finally, summarize the table into 120 words for a slide. So it will set it all off. And now we've got all of these things connected. See how quickly it's going. How cool is this? Now it's all connected. Not only will it be able to produce the response, which you can get out of Perplexity, but now can create a new Google Sheet. It's doing the Google Sheets now, done the research, does the research very quickly. Perplexity works super quick. Okay, so it's done its work, and it's given me the document here. And here we go, the top eight. It's given me links to them, so links to stories about them. Created this as a Google Sheets. Really cool. And if you'd have done this just in Perplexity, it would have done it inside, but it doesn't have that system to go off and create the document for you. So you may well have got a similar sort of response, but you would have then had to cut and paste the document into a sheet, whereas with the assistant turned on in Comet, then it can go off and do those things for you. Really, really cool. Let's move on. So this is the data, the sheet that it gave me. So what I'm going to do is open the assistant, and I'm going to say, using the EV competitor sheet, draft a one-page plan with sections on market, gap, offers, 90-day actions, create three prospect emails, about 80 to 100 words, no hype. So write a 60-second video script introducing the offer to decision makers. Let's see what we get. So we've done the analysis. Now we're asking assistant to go off and do some more things. Here's your one-page plan, the offer, 90-day actions. Done that in seconds. Subject, and then here are the three email variants. Practical EV charging solutions for your community. Flexible EV charging, no-cost surprises. And EV charging that works for your staff and visitors. So those are for businesses. So it's done it for local council, local authority. It's done it for SME fleet manager, and it's done it for general decision makers. Very, very cool. Really quick, just doing the business for you. Excellent. Hope you can see that. Okay, so how about doing a competitor analysis? So here I have opened the Specsaver website, and I've opened the Boots Opticians website, and I've said in Assistant, so I've called up Assistant, please generate a competitor analysis between Specsavers and Boots on designer sunglasses with prescription. See what we get? It's got both of those websites. I'm hoping it's going to analyze the websites and give us a competitor analysis. It's working quick. Both companies provide clear information, lots of offers. And it's given me a competitor analysis in seconds. If you're looking for a product, if you're looking to compare a particular piece of equipment you want to buy, etc., Specsavers got exclusive Elton John eyewear. Do with some of that. Boots has got all these other brands. Both got wide range, available in single vision lenses, included in offers. Widely available, all pricing includes frames and single vision lenses. Some exclusive collections. Get your Ray-Bans from Meta at Boots. Prices, glasses from £15, single vision. Buy one, get one free, over £150. See, really quick, really good competitor analysis. Just open both websites, ask for the analysis. Really good. You could obviously go in further, you know, identify a specific product and then say, give me a pricing differential between the two. If that's what you wanted. Really cool. Let's move on. Okay, you want to book hotels? You want to find and get a shortlist of hotels, populate the booking things, but wait until you actually do the booking. I'm still not sure I would let Comet go ahead and do the booking. So here we go. We've got a prompt. Compare 3 4-star hotels in Birmingham for the 29th of October to 31st of October. Show price, night cancellation policy, walk time to the ICC in Birmingham, produce a shortlist with links, pre-fill booking for the second option, but stop before payment. See what we get. It's doing a search. It's looking at TripAdvisor, etc. And this is the beauty of having the assistant. It can actually go to the website and then pre-populate the bookings. We've gone on to booking.com, identified a room, it's working. So what it did was it went on to booking.com and asked me to log in. I will make sure that it doesn't book me a room. I don't want a room in Birmingham. Here we go. It suggested the Leonardo, the Hyatt Regency, and the Hotel Garden Inn in Birmingham. Very nice. I can, of course, I can share this information. So it's booked. It made a booking for the Leonardo, the second option. It's already pre-filled. There we go. Go directly to your booking to finish. No payment has been taken. It gives you availability, etc. It's got the dates in. Two adults. I could go through and book that very easily. Very cool. And of course, I think as we get more confident with these things, we would be able to perhaps say, just go and book the room. I'm not there yet, but one day, maybe. One day soon, maybe. Okay, I hope you found that useful. And if you have, don't forget to give me a like and remember to subscribe as well. About 80% of people that watch my videos don't subscribe. So really cool if you subscribe. That would be great for me. Now, I think just as we're using these tools, these agent tools that can go off and do things, and assistant in Comet, absolutely that. It could go off, as you saw in the last demonstration, can go off and book a hotel room. I think be very careful, or send an email for you. Be very careful. I would always suggest that you first do it in draft mode. Once you're happy with it, you press send. Once you have approved any spend, you press pay, rather than let the AI do it right now. Because I think there it still does make errors. It still does get things wrong, and really worth checking before you actually press the button. And what I would suggest is that when you are putting in your payment details, etc., rather than give them to Comet, keep them private, stop all of the assistant stuff going on, put in the details, send them off, and then start it all up again. So you're not sort of sharing your important payment details. Hope you got some value out of that video. If you want to learn more about Perplexity, then have a look at this video here. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. I've been the professor. Bye-bye for now.